that's the sum total of my keyboard skills. But Alan, when I look at this, there's a clear pattern here, isn't there? And that must mean something to a pianist.
Yes, there is. If you look, for instance, just at the black notes, there are two and then three and two and then three. And it might help just to concentrate on this block of notes. You can see there are eight white and five black notes. And that chunk of notes is repeated over and over as you move up the keyboard. So that makes actually 13 notes in all. Let me play the first 12 of them.
And you're waiting for the final one, aren't you?
You're waiting for the final one. The 13th note is the same as the first note, but higher up. It's actually an octave above.
Well, that eight notes apart, is that?
That's eight notes apart. These are the eight notes that represent an octave, that's right. And the scale I played is the chromatic scale. The chromatic scale simply takes in all the notes.
But that didn't sound like a scale as I know it, which just goes do, re, mi. It seems to have very different intervals.
It is different. The chromatic scale simply covers every note, whereas the do, re, mi scale is actually the major scale. If I start with this note, which is C, and play, that's the do, re, mi scale, and that's the scale of C major. I only used white notes. If I started on that note, D, I'd have to throw in a couple of the black notes just to keep the same pattern of a major scale.
Okay. So they're just those two main kinds of scales?
No, there are others. A minor scale you may have heard of is quite common. Unfortunately, it's rather complicated. There are at least two forms of minor scale. But just to keep it very simple, if you concentrate on the first three notes of C major and then flatten the third note, that is, go down to the black note immediately below it, that's the flat, and play that scale, you get a simplified version of the minor scale.
Okay, it gives it a very different feel, doesn't it?
Yeah, a minor scale has a different feel. It's sort of rather sad, wistful sound.
Right. So using those three main kinds of scales then, can you play all the music there is in the world?
Not quite. If you go to other countries, for example, they don't use these 13 notes at all. For example, in India, an instrument like the sitar is tuned to many more than these 13 notes. But many of the folk tunes around the world are tuned to something called the pentatonic scale.
Five notes.
Five notes, and that's a very well-known scale. You'll know a lot of tunes. Let's take, for instance, just these black notes. And the sixth note to complete, but those five notes are the pentatonic scale. And there are tunes that you'd be familiar with, like Amazing Grace, for instance. Or Auld Lang Syne.
So can you only play those two on the black notes?
If you play in this key, but you can play in any key. I mean, I could have played that same tune using different notes. I'm only using white notes, but it's still a pentatonic scale, but in a different key.
So it's the pattern, isn't it, then? The intervals between the notes that's important.
Exactly. Whether it's a minor scale, chromatic, major, or pentatonic, it's the pattern between, or the intervals between the notes, that says what sort of scale it is.